Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my dear respected brothers and sisters. You are welcome, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this beautiful khatira and halaqa from DNA Center. Inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala, today, if you were following us last week, I talked about al-ihsan, the highest level of iman. I think all of us, we hear this hadith, the famous hadith, when Jibreel alayhi salam, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked him this hadith. So I would like to start with this hadith, inshallah, by saying, Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, Sayyidina Muhammad al-Nabi al-Ummi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man walah, Subhanaka Rabbana la ilma lana illa ma allamtana innaka anta al-alim al-hakim. Rabbana iftah baynana wa bayna qawmina bil-haqq wa anta khayrul fatihin. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي لا اله الا انت سبحانك انا كنا ظالمين لا اله الا انت سبحانك انا كنا ظالمين لا اله الا انت سبحانك انا كنا ظالمين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, last week we talked about the level of ihsan, and the level of ihsan, as I talked and shared with you some about level of ihsan, the highest level of iman. When Jibreel alayhi salam, he came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the type of sahabi, and he asked Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam some questions, and among these questions, this question, he said, mal ihsan ya Rasul Allah? He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al ihsan an ta'bud Allah ka annaka tara, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you see him, if you can't see him, He sees you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing you. Allah jalla jalalu is observing you. So when we have this feeling, and I would like to distinguish between two things. We have to distinguish between to know and to have our faith. To know, all of us we know. But who has this faith in his heart? Who has this feeling in his heart? Who is putting this pillar of iman in his heart? That pillar of iman, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us about the iman and tu'mina billahi wal yawm al-akhir wa malaikati, until the end of the pillars of iman. And to reach to this level of ihsan, we should have do some steps. All of us, we know that we are here in this life for test. We are not here in this life, we are not here in this life to be relaxed. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created us here in this life to establish and to build this earth for hereafter, for al-akhirah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, the last ayah from Surah Al-Kahf, he said, Jalla wa ala, Qul innama ana basharun mithlukum. Tell them, I am human like you. Yuha ilay. The only difference between you and I, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving me the wahi. يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد. That's okay. All of us, we know that. Look at the rest of the ayah, the second part, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said on the tongue of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, فَمَنْ كَانَ, whoever see, يرجو, wish to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I think all of us, we wish to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma ja'alna ya Rabbi min ibadika alladhina radita anhum wa radu anka ya Rabbal alameen. And فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ, if you are looking for to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what's the key? What's the steps to do that? فَلْيَعْمَلْ. Do. Do. Only just to do? No. With the condition on it. فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا. Don't make shirk in your ibadah. And shirk in intention, and shirk in ta'ah, shirk in ibadah, and shirk in everything. Make everything sincere, sincerity. Make your ibadah, sincere ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not for show off, not for the people, not for dunya, not for money, not for benefit. Just look for the benefit from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The main goal, the big benefit from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are looking for, forgiveness and mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from here, if you look at the title of the halaqa today, be with the winners. I think we are in the month of Ramadan, we are in something like competition. We are in real competition. It's not competition like competition in dunya to get trophy or to get award or to get a prize or something like that. No, the big and the great prize is al-Jannah. So to be with the winners, we need to work. We need to do some steps on the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not on the way of dunya. Because if we did that on the way of dunya, we will lose. So we will not be, we won't be from or with the winners. If we made our steps for dunya, we would be with the losers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us about the losers on the day of judgment. But I'm not going to talk about the losers because this is not our way. This is not our goal. Our goal, we are looking forward to be with the winners. The winners who? Who is the winners? If I ask you a question, what's the winning? What does it mean winning in your mind? If I asked you this question, what's the meaning to win in this life? Some of people, they could say, wallahi Sheikh, winning from my side, from my opinion, is to achieve what I'm looking for or to achieve or fulfill my goals, right? Some of people would say to collect money. If I collected the number that I'm working on to have it on that time, this is the meaning of the winning. Other people, they would say to have property. Other people say to have many things. But the real meaning of winning is to win al-Jannah. And before to win al-Jannah, to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us moved away from the hellfire. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran in Surah Al-Imran, verse number 185, He said, Jalla wa ala, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ. Allahu Akbar. Just to be moved a little bit away from the hellfire, then this is the first step. Second step is what? To enter Jannah. Here, Allah said that, فَقَدْ فَازْ فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us. This is not from my pocket. This is not from my mind. So, the first kind of winning is what? To make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala move me away from the hellfire, a little bit from the hellfire, عَذَابُ النَّارِ. Then after that, we are seeking the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, after that, we would be in Jannah. Here, we are the winners. But this is the first step or the first level of winning. This is not the highest step. Al-Mu'min, Al-Muslim, all the time, his goal on the top. He is looking for top of the top, best of the best. This is, we should, all of us, looking for that. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us about al-Jannah, أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةً. The item of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is what? Al-Jannah. It's expensive. But compare the price that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us about, the price for this item, for this al-Jannah. The price is what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He honored us by giving us the soul and the life and the money, and He prepared everything here in this life. And see the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. See the mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us. He created everything for us. And He prepared everything for us. And He guided us to the right way. And He guided us to how to be with the winners here as in this ayah. And in the meantime, from His mercy that He is giving us, sending some good deeds. He's sending some good deeds to us. To what? To reward us. Who is doing that in this life? So Allah said, Inna Allah ashtara min al-mu'minina. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He purchased from the believers. Inna Allah ashtara min al-mu'minina. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He purchased? Allah, He purchased that our soul, our money, our time, while he is the only, he gave it to us. Imagine that he is giving to us to sell it again or resell again, the one who gave it to us, to reward us. Think with me about it, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is dealing with us. How is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the most merciful for all of us, jalla wa ala. So from here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is guiding us to be with the winners by moving a little bit from the hellfire. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us how to be moved from the hellfire. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the authentic hadith, فَمَنْ أَحَبَّ whoever like أَنْ يُزَحْزَحَ عَنِ النَّارِ to be moved very little bit يُزَحْزَحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَيُدْخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَلْتَأْتِهِ مَنِيَّتُهُ وَهُوَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ Let's death come to him while he is believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he is believing in the day of judgment. وَلْيَأْتِ النَّاسَ الَّذِي يُحِبُّ أَنْ يُؤْتَى إِلَيْهِ What does it mean? What does it mean, ya Sheikh? وَلْيَأْتِ النَّاسَ الَّذِي يُحِبُّ أَنْ يُؤْتَى إِلَيْهِ I'll give you an example. For example, I like people to respect me. So here I have to respect people. So I'm giving the people what I like to have. I like to see the people happy, for example. So I have to make them happy, to be happy from them, with them. I like people to cooperate and deal with me. I have to cooperate. I have people, many different things like that. So I have to give the people what I like to have. Again, the meaning of this hadith, I have to give the people what I like to have. I give them the same way I like to wish, I like to have. So if I wish they like me, I have to like them. If I wish they respect me, I have to respect them. If I like them to give me, I have to give them. I have to appreciate them. I have many things. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَلْيَأْتِ النَّاسَ الَّذِي يُحِبُّ أَنْ يُؤْتَى إِلَيْهِ From the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the rights of the servants. So the winning or al-fawz, many or three kinds. Number one, al-fawzul mubin, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran, and this is the first one that we talk about it right now, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, after that, Al-Fawzul Kabir, the third one is what? Al-Fawzul Azim, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran about it. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran about Al-Fawzul Kabir or Al-Fawzul Azim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the rest of ayah, what I said right now, إن الله اشترى من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم بأن لهم الجنة يقاتلون في سبيل الله they are fighting for the sake of Allah فيقتلون they will kill and فيقتلون ويقتلون he will be killed by their enemy وعدا عليه it's a promise from Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the end of the ayah Allah said فاستبشروا have joy فاستبشروا Have a good news, happy news from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بِبَيْعِكُمْ الَّذِي بَايَعْتُمْ بِهِ You sold your soul for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so Allah will reward you from the same thing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He told us about al-fawz in al-dunya or in al-akhirah, He told us, وَبِتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to you, look for, seek, to be with the winners and look forward to be in Ad-Dar al-Akhirah with the people. It's not the meaning, I mean the rest of ayah. In another ayah as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us to do something to be with those people. So first step on the way of winning, to move, to be moved a little bit from the hellfire. Number two, al-fawz al-azim, to enter Jannah. And this is, they call it what? They call it Al-Fawzul Kabir. Al-Fawzul Kabir, that now, the first step, we are away from the hellfire. We moved. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we be moved from the hellfire. Then, number two, we entered Jannah. Number three, to be in the highest level in Jannah. In the highest level in Jannah, yes, this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا. Fear, O believers, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say the truth. Say the truth. قولوا الصدق قولوا الحق قولوا كلمة طيبة. Say a good words. Say a righteous word. Say كلمة طيبة كلمة صادقة for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا. If you did that, Allah said يصلح لكم أعمالكم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide you to the correct and the right deeds, in the right way, in the right path. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah will forgive your sins. وَمَنْ, whoever, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ, whoever will obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. Allahu Akbar. فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. Why? Because وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, in another ayah, whoever will obey Allah and His Messenger, فَأُولَٰئِكَ, those people. With who, ya Allah? With who? فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored and blessed them. By themselves? No. With themselves? No. مَعَ الَّذِينَ, مَعَ, with, مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ. From who, ya Allah? مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ. Allahu Akbar. Me, I could be with the prophets in the levels, in the highest level in Jannah? Yes, you can. You, my brother, my sister, my all community, everywhere. You could be with those people. Obey Allah and His Messenger. And listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And listen to His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ. See, مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ. والصديقين, the most truthful people. صالحين, righteous people. والشهداء, وحسن أولئك رفيقا. This is the best group. Those people, the best friend in الآخرة, in the best place in Jannah. ما شاء الله. وحسن أولئك رفيقا. ذلك الفضل من الله. This is a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I think, my brother and sister, If we are thinking about the winners, I think, wallahi, everything we would pay here in this life compared to the reward in al-akhirah, it would be nothing. It's very cheap. Why? How much I can pay for al-akhirah? Sadaqah? How much I pay in sadaqah? For sadaqah? $10,000? We could pay this price for dinner. And then this food will go, as you know where. And but we could pay the same price for sadaqa jariya, and the good deeds, the good rewards still running, come to us even after death in the grave. We don't know. By this sadaqa jariya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how will reward us? To feed al-miskeen, to help needy people, to give some people some food, to give them some clothes, to do something good for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To keep doing, you know, brother and sister, we could delay anything here in this life. I wanted to go somewhere. Maybe I can go tomorrow. I decided to go next week, next year. I wanted to visit my friend. I could delay it. I wanted to do so and so. I could delay it. The only thing, we shouldn't delay it to do good deeds. To do fi'l al-khayr, to hurry up, to be rush. Why? This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us. وَسَارِعُوا. Come quick to me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling you. Come quick to me, my servant. إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. See, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, come very quick. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. وَجَنَّةٍ, paradise. عَرْضُهَا كَعَرْضِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. In another ayah, عَرْضُهَا كعرض السماوات والأرض, عرضها السماوات والأرض. Prepared for who, ya Allah? للمتقين, for the pious people. Who, ya Allah? الذين ينفقون, they are spending. في السراء, in good time, in the hard time, in tough time, they are spending. والكاظمين الغيظة, If some people, they made them angry, they kept and they control the anger inside themselves. They could do that, but they kept inside themselves for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. They are forgiving the people. Someone, he did something wrong to me, I'll forgive him for the sake of Allah. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. See, this is the steps and this is the acts, this is the deeds. If we did, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will like us. So, أُولَئِكَ, those people, جَزَاءُهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ, not one jannah, jannat, تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. This is the best ajr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the best reward. This is the best winning. وَذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in the Quran. My dear respected brothers and sisters, all the time we are asking this question by the end of the month of Ramadan. Who was the winner? So we can congratulate him. And who was the loser? Forget about the loser, because we don't want to be with those people. We want to be, we'd like to be, we wish to be, we will work to be with the winners. Do these steps. Still have another steps on the way of the winners. I'll continue with you, inshallah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next week, ibnillah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'll show you, I'll tell you, I'll share with you how to apply and how to practice these steps until to be with the winners in al-akhirah, in Ramadan first, then the rest of the year, then in al-akhirah, bi-ithnillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He gathered us here in this dunya, on this ta'ah, on ibadah, in the month of Ramadan, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather all of us in al-firdaws al-a'la, ma'an nabiyyina, wa-s-siddiqina, wa-shuhada'i, wa-s-salihin, wa-hasuna ula'ika rafiqa. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa an. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. سبحانك يا ربنا لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آل نبينا محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وأصلح لنا أحوالنا واهد لنا قلوبنا ويسر لنا أمورنا. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا. اللهم عافنا واعف عنا. اللهم ارض عنا وعن جميع المسلمين واجعلنا اللهم من عبادك الفائزين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اكتبنا في رمضان من عتقائك من النار. اللهم اجعلنا في رمضان من المقبولين الفائزين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اختم لنا رمضان بالغفران والعتق من النيران برحمتك يا رحيم يا رحمن. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. نسألك اللهم حبك وحب من يحبك وحب كل عمل يقربنا إليك وإلى حبك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. تقبل اللهم صيامنا. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وتلاوتنا للقرآن. اللهم أكرمنا بكرامة القرآن وزيننا بزينة القرآن واجعله شفيعا لنا في الدنيا والآخرة يا رحيم يا رحمن. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. نسألك اللهم أن تغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا. اللهم أصلح لنا أحوالنا واهد لنا أولادنا ويسر لنا أمورنا واقض لنا حوائجنا. اللهم توفنا وأنت راض عنا واجعل خير أعمالنا خواتيمها وخير أيامنا يوم أن نلقاك واختم بالباقيات الصالحات أعمالنا. اجعل خير أعمالنا خواتيمها وخير أيامنا يوم أن نلقاك واختم بالباقيات الصالحات أعمالنا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك ونصلي ونسلم على عبدك ونبيك وسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ربنا دعوناك كما أمرتنا فاستجب لنا يا ربنا كما وعدتنا، وصل اللهم وسلم على حبيبك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا for joining. جزاكم الله خيرا for watching and listening. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you and reward all of you and accept all your good deeds. جزاكم الله كل خير. Inshallah, wish to see you next week if Allah give us a life. Inshallah, all of us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.